Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at today's stock market. It's coming up to 7:45 on the East Coast, and stock index futures are down across the board. So far, it looks like we're going to have a lower open at 9:30 Tuesday morning. Let's start off today's presentation and look at the major stock market indexes that we follow. Now, Monday was another interesting day. The futures were up in the pre-market. We opened higher, but lost most of those gains going into the close. Here's the VIX. The VIX traded below the lower channel line intraday, but actually closed higher on the day. So 2 days in a row, we've been in the channel. That, of course, is the neutral zone. If we want the market to continue to move lower, then we need to head up above the upper channel line. If we want the market to move higher, then we want it to close below 1451 on Tuesday. Looking at the S&P 500, we certainly traded above last Wednesday's high, but didn't close there, and we did close lower on the day. On Tuesday, we're looking for a close above the upper channel line, above 1982.56. And for the NASDAQ 100, again, we traded above the Wednesday high just slightly, but certainly did not close there. We closed lower on the day, and we're down in the pre-market this morning. So for things to change for the NASDAQ 100, that lower channel line is moving lower daily, so we're looking for a close above 4057.18. And looking at the TSX actually closed below the previous day's low, which is bearish, nowhere near last Wednesday's high. And we're looking for a close above 15,048 on Tuesday to give us a new daily buy signal for the TSX. The global Dow actually closed higher on the day on Monday. The Dow itself traded right up to the upper channel line, down to the lower channel line, closed down 17 points on the day. Still on a sell signal for the Dow. The Russell and the ZAX microcap traded up to the lower channel line on Friday and Monday, and reversed, both closing lower on the day. The TSX Venture Exchange continued to make lower lows on Monday. We saw bank stocks trade up through the upper channel line in the U.S., still traded into the channel yesterday, but closed below the lower channel line in Canada. There's credit card stocks up to the upper channel line on Monday, but still on a sell signal, no change there. Energy stocks were slightly higher in the U.S., slightly lower in Canada. Looking at the gold sector for the XAU, we had an inside day on Monday, lower low for the TSX Gold Index. Semiconductors had another wild day on Monday, closed lower on the day. And there's the transports, a wild day on Monday for the transports, traded through the upper channel line in intraday in the morning, and then closed lower on the day going into the close. Still on a sell signal, no change there for the transports. Next up, let's take a look at the bonds. Starting off in Chicago, we see the 30-year bond closing higher on Monday, hasn't taken out last week's highs. There's the Vanguard Total Bond ETF taking out last week's highs, but not closing above them. And then looking at the iShares Universal Bond ETF, did take out and closed above last week's high. So things are looking pretty positive in the bond market. Next up, let's take a look at currencies. Now, we saw a pullback in the U.S. dollar after Friday's big up day, but still trading above the upper channel line. We saw a reversal in the euro, still trading below the lower channel line. Possible top for the U.S. dollar, possible bottom for the euro. The British pound had an inside day on Monday. Japanese yen had an inside day trading back in the channel, as did the Canadian dollar trading back into the channel on Monday. We need a close above 90.10 to give us a buy signal for the Canadian dollar on Tuesday. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices. First up, we're looking at the PowerShares Commodity Index ETF. It was up 1.27% yesterday, still trading below the lower channel line. Copper traded into the channel yesterday, a close above 36.82 would give us a new buy signal on Tuesday. Gold traded up, filled the open gap before backing off, and it's down ever so slightly in the pre-market this morning. A close above 117.29 would give us a buy signal on Tuesday. Platinum had an inside day on Monday, no change there. Silver up to the lower channel line on Monday, A close above 1687 on Tuesday would give us a new daily buy signal. Crude oil was up yesterday, still below the lower channel line, no change there. Gasoline was up, still below the lower channel line, no change there. And natural gas was down yesterday, back on a sell signal. Natural gas has been trading in a channel for a while now, and we had an open gap here that was acting as resistance. That open gap is still holding. We've got natural gas found resistance at the 100-day moving average. So the moving averages are coming down. You can see the 50, the 100, and then the 200-day moving average. If you want to become bullish on natural gas, and we're coming into the winter, who doesn't want to be bullish? What we really need to see is a move above the 200-day moving average. That would start to tell us that new money is coming into this market. Now, if we start taking out the recent lows, then look for a move down a couple of bucks. But I wouldn't do anything until we see a breakout of the recent lows or the recent highs before I do anything in natural gas. Last up this morning, let's take a look at some intraday charts. Starting off, looking at the 60-minute flypaper channel for the VIX. The VIX punched through the bottom of the flypaper channel for an hour or so and then came back in. With the VIX below the flypaper channel, you want to be bullish. Above the flypaper channel, you want to be bearish. Coming into Tuesday, we're on an intraday buy signal for the VIX, so that's bearish for the market. If the VIX were to close on an hourly basis before below 1482, that's 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30, 3:30, then that would be positive for stocks if we could get the VIX below 1482. Looking at the S&P 500 cash index, we're coming into Tuesday on an intraday buy signal. That didn't change yesterday. Things turned negative, and we've got red bars here, but we never closed below the lower channel line. So a close on Tuesday below 1962.55 would give us a new intraday sell signal, and that probably indicates we want to go back down and retest last week's low. Similar situation for the NASDAQ 100. We're looking for an hourly close below 4013.88. And for the TSX, we're looking for a close above 14,817 to give us an intraday buy signal on Tuesday. We're coming into Tuesday already on an intraday sell signal. Okay, folks, that's all for Tuesday morning. Futures are still down in the pre-market this morning, so we're still expecting lower prices at the open at 9:30. I'll be back in a little while with a look at the NASDAQ 10 most actively traded stocks from Monday's trading action.